today, I almost didn't start Vlogmas. I almost forgot in earnest, and then I was like, most of the day is gone, what do I do? I already began opening my book advent calendar down there. I'll show you at the end of the video what today's book was for the advent calendar if you are interested. But then it occurred to me, do you like the Christmas pudding pillow? But then it occurred to me that there is something that I could do, and that is share my December TBR. So that's what this video is going to be. And I'm going to hold this pillow the entire time because I kind of love it, to be honest. Now, in order to decide what my TBR is each month, I like to use the Bookish First bingo that comes out every month. And I will display the Bookish bingo table for December right here. And you can see all of the prompts that are available. I'll also link it down below. But I'm just going to share the prompts that I'm deciding to fill. And if I get the 5 in a row on the bingo table, it means that I get a book buying credit. This is my little reward system that I have devised for myself to avoid buying too many books. So let's start with set during a winter holiday. For this prompt, I have chosen A Court of Frost and Starlight. I have been reading the ACOTAR series for the past few months now. I think I started it in September, and this series, man. To say that it is just smut is kind of like saying that the French only eat snails, you know? It's definitely like part of it. It's part of the experience, but it's so much more than that. And I just urge anyone who feels like it's just silly nonsense, damn, it's so much better than that. So this book is technically like 3.5 in this series. I think it's just a novella, but it is set in like the winter solstice holiday of the world, which is kind of Christmas. And it also, I believe, if I remember from previous exposition in the series, it's also the main character's birthday, which I think is going to be an interesting combination to explore. But yeah, really excited to get this going. I am in the last 70 pages of A Court of Wings and Ruin, and it's intense. I'm listening to the audiobook as like a way to fill the prompt from the last book bingo table. And I'm listening to it, and once in a while I'll just stop and I just go, what? So yeah, that is that prompt. Prompt number 2 that I will be using is published in December. Now, I try not to buy new books as they're being released. I tend to buy mostly secondhand, but I got given this book in December last year, and is published in December. So I were doing Heartstopper Volume 5, which is great because I read the little novella this winter at the end of last month, and it kind of takes place, like I've been watching the show as well, and it's like in the middle of the season that's currently out, and after that I haven't actually continued watching because I don't know what happens. So once I read this, I can finally finish watching the show. It's cute, it's fun, it'll only take a day to read because it's a graphic novel, I'm keen. I'm leaving the middle space blank for the time being because on another prompt list from Dimmix, which is the other way that I choose what to read, I need to fill a prompt which is a book that was gifted to you. So I'm waiting to see if I get any books for Christmas, and if I do, then that will be what I read, and I'm going to fill it that blank space with that book. For the prompt of the last book I read in 2024, I'm going to read How Decent Folk Behave by Maxine Benaber Clark. I got this book a couple of years ago as like a little birthday present for myself, but I still haven't gotten around to it. Maxine Benaber Clark is an Australian author, African-Australian author, and her work is considered creative nonfiction, which is a genre that I am very, very interested in and would like to attempt writing and getting published in one day. But for the time being, I'm just still learning about the form. So this is the book that I'm using for the last book of the year because it is kind of more like poetry prose, which will again be very quick to get through. And for the final prompt, it is an author that I would like to read more of in 2025. And I feel like I got really, really lucky with this find. I have chosen Funny Story by Emily Henry. This is not the usual way that I buy books. Like I prefer books that are like the standard paperback size, as that gets released like a year after the initial release. I know this is a new release, but I actually found this at a thrift shop. It's in pretty rough condition, not gonna lie. Like the back, that's coming apart. Like that's the cover. But I was absolutely stoked to just find it for $3, which meant that I could read it and I can either pass it on to someone who would appreciate it, or if it's in too rough a condition, it can just go in the bin. But it also fills the prompt of the of picking a nominee from the Dimmicks Book of the Year category, which fills the Dimmicks prompt. I have read Book Lovers and, what is it, Beach Read by Emily Henry, and both were pretty great. But this is a fun opportunity for me to read a new release from Emily Henry. And yeah, it's always a good time. Just a light, fluffy, romance-y sort of read. So this is my TBR pile for the rest of the year. Oh, the rest of the year, December, only 1 month left. Wow. It is a modest TBR pile, but I find that if I set the goals small and I reward myself for it, then it actually just spurs me on to be a more consistent reader. Anyway, I'll show you the bookish advent calendar system that I've got going on. So I've got all the books that I have yet to read on my bookshelf. Not all of them, there's still some unread books, but I got a chunk of them and I wrapped them up as little presents to myself a couple of months ago. So I've actually forgotten what is in each of these. I have an idea, but I've mostly forgotten. And I already opened number one today, which was The 10,000 Doors of January by Alex E. Harrow. And she also wrote The Once and Future Witches, which was like the suffragette movement plus witches. Always a good time. So yeah, the rest of the evening is just going to be getting ready for tomorrow. I've got work starting at around lunchtime and into the evening. Got pet photos in the evening, which is always fun. And yeah, that's the rest of my evening. Just going to have a shower, relax, and happy Vlogmas, everyone. We will see you tomorrow. You know what it's like when you don't realize how thirsty you are until you have your first sip, and then it's like, I actually am a big fan of the Stanley Cup knockoffs that you can get from Kmart. I can't speak for how it compares to the brand name because I never had it, but it keeps my drink cold literally for like 24 hours. It's great. And it has improved my hydration since I've gotten it. I feel like to hype myself up for Vlogmas, I'm just going to watch some old Vlogmas episodes of the YouTube queen, Zoella. Yes, I think that is where I'm going to end it here tonight. Good night. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.